Welcome to this video. My name's Jason Morell, and today I'm going to show you the tracking and comments feature in Microsoft Word and try and demystify this strange, confusing creature that it is. You may have had documents in the past where you've done some work and some strange things have happened to the document. You get weird formatting happening like this. You get some markings in the left margin like this. You know, what is it all about? Now, this is actually tracking in action. What I want to do is to explain why this happens and how you can use this tracking feature to your advantage. Let me close this document down and let's start with a brand new one. I'm going to type a simple statement and this will just give us some sample text to work with. Now, first of all, the idea of tracking changes is that you've written a document and you want to get feedback and comments from other people before you finalize it and send it out or distribute it. Now, what tracking changes lets you do is to make the changes directly on the document itself. And let's say you sent this out to 10 different people. All of those people can make the changes on the same document and it records who made the change and what they said. At the end of the process, you as the document's creator can then go through it and actually say, well, this is a good comment. I'm going to take some action on that. Or, yeah, this proposed change is good. I'm going to accept it. Or maybe it's not so good, in which case you reject it. So you have the choice at the end of the process as to what to do with the feedback that's come back. Changes fall into three main categories. There's changes to the content itself. There's formatting changes. And there's comments. Now, comments aren't really part of the tracking changes process, but it all works in together. With a new document, your tracking is turned off as a default setting. So to turn the tracking on, you need to go to the Review tab at the top of your screen, find the Track Changes button there, and it's actually a split icon. So if you click the top half there, the picture, it turns the tracking on for you. If you choose the second half, the drop-down section, you get two choices. You can either track the changes, turn it on, or you can lock the tracking. That means turn the Track Changes feature on, and you can only switch it off if you have the password. So for this one, let's just choose Track Changes. Tracking is now on, which means any changes we make will get recorded. There are three types of change. You can either add stuff, remove stuff, or change stuff. Let's do an example of each. So let's say I come down here, I press enter for a new line and type some new text. You can see there's a marking in the left-hand margin there, and it always adds one of these marks to indicate that somewhere along this line there's been a change. In this case, that's new text. So it's a new content, stuff that's been added, and it marks that with an underline. If we select a sentence here and delete it, again, it puts the marking in the left-hand margin there, but this time it scores through the text, and that indicates that the text is going to get removed if this change is accepted later on. The final type is a change. So let's say we take this word coordinated, and let's replace it with in check. So you can see the original word is struck through, the new content is underlined, which indicates it's new content. Other types of content you may add into your document at some point are tables and images. So let's say we add or insert a table. Any size is fine. Again, the marking down the left-hand side. If you look closely at the table, you'll see the cells are coloured light blue, and that's the colour that's used to indicate new content or new cells in your table. Later on, if you decide to delete some columns or rows or cells, or you insert some new ones, or you merge cells or split cells, all of those kind of actions on a table have different colour coding. And I'll show you where to change that a bit later on. Let's add an image. So under Insert Pictures, any image is fine. Let's resize it. Now, when I click away from the picture, can you see the red underline underneath the picture there? Now, just like for new text, this is indicating that the picture is new content. It's been added since the review process started. And again, in the left-hand margin, the marker, just like before. So that's content. Let's now look at some formatting changes. So let's say we go up to the top here. Let's choose maybe a couple of words and make it bold. Okay, or maybe we turn the highlighter on. Choose a word or a phrase and highlight it. Now, all of these kind of things, these are formatting changes. And you'll notice they're actually indicated a little bit differently to content changes. So where the content was actually marked inline, any comments or any formatting changes are included in balloons. That's the official name for these entries over here. Now, it can actually change the way each of those is displayed if you wanted to. If you come back to the Review tab here and click the Show Markup, it gives you some options. Now, firstly, it's just saying, do you want to mark up the comments, anything you insert or delete, or anything you format? So all of those are ticked, so all of those are going to get marked up in some way. Where it says balloons, you can come across here and there's an option that says show all revisions in balloons, balloons being the stuff down the right-hand side there. So if instead of showing the markup on the content itself, you can actually say, let's show it in balloons instead. So it looks like this. Your original document remains clean, but all the comments and all the feedback that's given appears on the right-hand side, but everything is in balloons. The other option under show markup and balloons is to show all revisions in line. Okay, so that includes any formatting changes that may have happened. But the default is to show only the comments and formatting in balloons and any content changes in line. There's also an option here for specific people. Now at the moment, there's only one person that's had any sort of input into this document, but maybe eventually it's going to go around, say, 10 or 15 different people, all of whom are going to input in some sort of way. Now let me close this for a second. Let's go to this thing here called a launcher and then change username. And I'm going to make this one Fred Smith. Initials FS. And OK that. So now let's say I make some sort of other change. So maybe I'll choose a sentence here and delete it. You'll see how the color coding is now different. This color code is a new color that belongs to Fred Smith. If we come to where it says show markup and specific people, you'll see two people listed now, Joe Bloggs and Fred Smith. Each one has a tick box next to it, which means if you untick the people you don't want to see at this moment, it only shows the feedback from the people that are still ticked. In this case, that one comment from Fred Smith is the only thing that's now showing on the document. So this is a way for you to filter down comments that you're looking at. So maybe there's a person in your list of 10 who you have a lot of respect for. They always come back with good feedback, and you want to look at their comments and feedback first. And once you've done all that, you can then look at everybody else's and see if there's anything else that is worth including. It's that kind of situation. So under show markup, specific people, this is a way to filter down person by person or group by group. So I just turned all the feedback back on. Now next in the group here is reviewing pane. You can either show the reviewing pane horizontal, which means it appears down the bottom, or vertical, which means it appears on the left-hand side by there. Now this is a summary of all the changes that have been proposed, a sequential list of the changes. So in your document, like all the changes we made here is on the same page because it's only a small sample we're looking at. But in the real world, you might have, say, a 100-page document. The first change might be on page 1. The next change might be on page 12 or page 25 or page 50. So there's these huge gaps in between the changes. The advantage of using this reviewing pane is that everything is listed sequentially, just as a list. So you can scan through and see what has been changed. So you can turn this on or off at any point. The last option in this group is the all markup at the top there. The proper name for that is called display for review, and all markup is the default option. All markup means it shows all the inline content changes with the marking on the left-hand border there, plus any balloons for your feedback or comments. If you want to simplify the markup a little bit, there's one option here called simple markup, and it removes all the changes in the inline content itself, but it still indicates it quite clearly with a marker on the left there to say that there's been some sort of change on this line. Other options here say original. So this throws you back to the original text before any changes were proposed, in case you want to check it for something. And no markup, the old name for this was final, and it shows how the document would look right now if you were to accept all the currently proposed changes. So I'm going to change that to all markup, go back to how we were. One thing I haven't touched on yet is the comments. Now comments are a standalone feature, but they work with tracking changes quite nicely. They're often used together. Before I show you how this works, let me quickly go back to the show markup option and just show only the comments and formatting balloons, because the comments are going to appear down here in balloons. So let's say I choose a paragraph down here, and I go to new comment and click, and it's given me a space now to put my comment. So I might say something like, maybe shorten this paragraph. So comments can be used to kind of suggest things, bring attention to things, all that kind of stuff. And it's up to you at the end of the day whether you act on these comments or not. You'll notice that the comments have a reply button next to them. So once somebody has made a comment, somebody else might chime in with something to add to that, or to clarify something, or to add a bit of weight behind it to say, yes, this is important. So all of those kind of things. So what you get is the original comment, and then lots of people chipping in to further that conversation. So let's imagine now that the document's been around all the people, it's come back to you, and there's all these kind of feedback and different comments that people have made throughout the document. You now have to decide which bits you want to accept, which bits you want to reject, and also take into account any comments that have been made and take action where appropriate. So first of all, the changes group here. This is to do with the feedback only, the tracking only. It doesn't take into account the comments. Your two main options here are to either accept or reject each proposed change. The other two buttons here navigate between each change. So wherever you happen to be, this one will show the next change that's been proposed. This one will show the previous change that was proposed. So let's say I press Control Home to go back to the top of the document. That way we're starting from the top and working through. We'll then click the next change, and it highlights the first change in the document. Now I'm looking at that sentence and thinking, no, I don't want to delete that. So on this first one, I might reject that change. So under the reject button, the dropdown, I'm going to reject just that change. You'll see there are other options there to reject all the changes in the document as well. In this case, just the one. If I then click next change, it highlights the next thing that was changed. In this case, it's just a formatting change, and I might say, okay, that's fine. So let's accept that and move on to the next one. Next one is a highlighting change. I don't want to do that, so let's reject it. Now let's say I've scanned through the rest of the document, and like all the other changes that are in there, I'm happy with. So what I can do instead is to click the drop-down on Accept and accept all changes. That then accepts everything else that hasn't yet been addressed. That's the tracking of the changes. The comments are in this other section here. So just like you get next and previous change, you get a next and previous comment button. So as you go through here, there's only two comments in the whole thing, but it will scan between them. You as the designer can look at each comment and take action if it's appropriate. Once you're done, delete it. So I've now gone through, I've deleted all the comments that were in the document, and we're now back to a clean document. This is like the final version. Once you've been through and accepted or rejected all the changes, you should switch the track changes feature off. So going back to the button here, we then click the main button, or if you went to the drop-down section, you'd choose the track changes here, which is just an on-off switch, it's a toggle. We're now back in safe mode, which means if we make changes in the document, the tracking is not going to take effect. Some final options for you. If we go to this launcher and choose the advanced options here, what we see here is all the settings regarding how the markup is going to look. So if we consider this top section, okay, the insertions, any new content we added is going to underline it in this color. Now where it says by author, that means that the first author was red, the next one was blue, and every subsequent author has a different color. So you can actually go through and by color identify the author. Deletions are marked with a strike through. All of these can be changed, of course. So you might want to bold it or italic it or double underline it, something like that. And again, you can set the color for it. Where it says change lines, this is referring to that marking in that left-hand margin, so the vertical marker that indicates there's been some change on that line. And just to finish off this video today, there's one final thing you can do to kind of lock down your document against further changes. So go to your File tab, go to the Info section if you're not there already, and go to where it says Protect Document. And the very first option says Mark as Final. And as the description says, it lets readers know that the document is final and it makes it read only. And that prevents further changes from happening. So if you then want to distribute it, you don't want other changes to happen in the meantime, this is the option to choose. So I hope this video has answered some questions for you around tracking and comments. If you found the video useful, give it a thumbs up underneath the video here. If you didn't find it useful, give it a thumbs down. That's fine. Just maybe write a quick comment to say why you didn't find it useful. If you'd like further comment like this, feel free to subscribe. That way you'll get notified as soon as new content is published. Otherwise, I'll see you in the next video.